where we're just looking for some of the remnants of the railway that was here.
Here we are today in this amazing piece of community archaeology, which really we should have done 30 or 40 years ago, but nobody's ever got round to doing before, exploring Incline Top in Goathland.
My husband looked on the website for something to do with our grandson, who's six, last week, and it was a pouring wet day. We didn't really know what to do with him, so we came over to have a look what they were doing. And stayed 2.5 hours, fascinated by what we saw, so we decided we would volunteer.
What's Incline Top? Well, at one level, it's just this strange little field just off the main street of Goathland. And it's quite well known in the sense that it's running through it one of the most popular footpaths in the national park, the old line from Gromont to Goathland. And that path is part of the route of the Whitby-to-Pickering railway.
Of course, the railway that was here was from 1836 to 1865. It's in two stages. The first one was the simpler horse-drawn system. But what we're really concentrating is when the York North Midland Railway took over in 1845 and basically reconstructed the site in 1847. Locomotives were from York. They couldn't go down the incline. So the locomotives had to be taken off at that point and run back to be serviced as an engine shed that we think is over there inside the road, and then turned on this turntable. This is a very early turntable, it's probably about 39-foot in diameter. After the 1860s, turntables were a lot bigger and the early ones were destroyed, so finding this is a very fine thing to do, a good find.
I enjoyed it. We've met some nice people and learning as we go along, because I knew nothing about it, how to go about digging. So I enjoyed it.